So a very good morning, students. So in this class we are going to discuss the ROC of an Z transform. So in that slide, so we can discuss. So limit m tends to infinity where x of minus m into x of m minus 1, which is equal to r of greater than 0, which x of minus z converges if limit m tends to infinity modulus of x of minus m minus 1 into z power m plus 1 and x of minus m into z power m, which is equal to limit m tends to infinity modulus x of minus m minus 1 divided by x of minus m and modulus of z less than 1. If modulus of z less than limit m tends to infinity where modulus of x of minus m divided by x of minus m minus 1, which is equal to r. As a result, the ROC factor of x minus of s is modulus of z less than r, and combining the result, the ROC of x of z is r less than modulus of s less than r, which lies between r, and ROC is the ring when r plus less than r. No ROC if r minus less than r plus and x of z does not exist. So this is a ROC concept. If it is a ROC is a ring when r plus less than r, and no ROC if r minus less than r and x of z does not exist. So this is the main concept of the ROC. And this is a z plane. We have a real and imaginary part, and r plus is a ROC with the region of convergence if r greater than z, modulus of z greater than r. So that is the ROC lies, converge the exterior part of the unit circle. So the first figure shows the exterior part of the unit circle. It is of the signal is causal signal. So whether it may be a positive one, it is a exterior part of the unit circle. So in that case, this also is a z plane here. R mean modulus of z less than r means anticausal signal. If we have a real and imaginary part, in that case, the ROC converge and the interior part of the unit circle. So this is the difference between causal signal and non-causal signal. If the third signal shows the both ROC causal and non-anticausal signal. So if it is a causal signal and non-causal signal means in between the inner circle, that is exterior part of the, we have a two inner circle. We have two unit circle and exterior part means the exterior part of the inner circle. And if it is causal signal means interior part of the causal signal means the z planes looks like that. If ROC is for x plus of z into x minus of z and x of z. So this is the basic concept of the ROC and for both causal and anticausal signal. So what we know that what does mean by causal signal and non-causal signal. And the causal signal is nothing but it represents what it depends only the present and past. And the anticausal means it present. I mean, it depends the future value of the signal. I mean, poles and zeros values of z for which x of z which is equal to zero are the zeros of x of z, and values of z for which x of z which is equal to infinity so are the poles of x of z. So this is a concept of anticausal and causal signal and both causal and anticausal signals for both poles and zeros. And which first one is x of z which is lies between which is equal to 0 is called 0, and values of r which x of z lies between the poles are x of z. And in many real world applications, x of s is represented as a rational function where x of z which is equal to p of z divided by q of z is a transfer function, and pole modulus of, summation n which is equal to k which is equal to 0 to m bk into z power k divided by summation k which is equal to 0 to n ak into z power k, factorizing p of z and q of z, it can be written as and x of z which is equal to b0 and z minus d1 and z minus d2 and so on up z minus dm. So divided by a0 into z minus c1 and z minus c2 up to z minus cn. And first, the example is determine z transform of x of n is equal to a power n into u of n. So where u of n is a unit step function. So what does mean by unit step function? Means unit step function is that is u of n which is equal to 1 when n greater than or equal to 0, which is equal to 0 for n lies n which is equal to 0. So we have studied in elementary signal, unit step function, unit impulse, like that we have studied in elementary signal. So for that the unit a of n into u of n, where u of n is a unit step function that determine the condition when the DTFT of x of n exists. And what's the formula for x of, I mean, z transform? X of z which is equal to summation n which is equal to minus infinity plus infinity a power n into u of n into z power minus 1. So by removing u of n unit step function, it is a causal signal. So like the limit lies between n which is equal to 0 to infinity and a power n into z power minus 1. It can be written as a into z power minus 1 to the whole power n. According to x of z converges it, summation n which is equal to 0 to infinity. So modulus of a into z power minus 1 the whole power n less than infinity. So and applying the ratio test, they converge. The condition is modulus of a into z power minus 1 less than 1. It lies between modulus of z greater than modulus of a. It has a causal signal which lies a unit circle in the ROC. The unit circle lies between the exterior part of the unit circle. In that case, if it is x of n into u of n minus n and if it is an anticausal signal, means it is an interior part of the unit circle. So that is the main thing. And we cannot write modulus of z greater than a because a may be a complex where it has computed in real and imaginary part, and because of complex number. And for x of z greater than modulus of a, x of s is computed as x of z which is equal to summation n which is equal to 0 to infinity and a into z power minus 1 the whole power n which is equal to and 1 minus a into z power minus infinity divided by 1 minus a into z power minus 1 which is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus a into z power minus 1 which is equal to z divided by z minus a. So together with ROC, the z transform of modulus of n a power n into u of n is x of z which is equal to z divided by z minus a. So where modulus of z greater than a, modulus of z greater than modulus of a. It is clear that x of z has a 0 at z which is equal to 0 and pole at z which is equal to 0 and z which is equal to a. Using we substitute z which is equal to e power j omega to obtain x of e power j omega which is equal to e power j omega divided by e power j omega minus a. So here instead of z you substitute e power minus j omega. That is x of z which is equal to summation n which is equal to minus infinity plus infinity x of n into z power minus n means z, I mean x of instead of s you substitute is e power j omega, means we can get x of e power j omega divided by x of e power j omega minus a modulus of e power j omega which is equal to 1. So in that case the modulus of a greater than 1. So in that case also the ROC, that is the units, I mean ROC converges the exterior part of the unit circles. As a result of existing condition for DTFT is x of n, so where is modulus of a less than 1. So in that case, so the DTFT of t, x of n is a signal, is anticausal signal. So otherwise it is DTFT does not exist. In general the DTFT x of e power j omega exists if it is ROC include the unit circle, if x of z greater than modulus of a includes and modulus of z each is equal to 1 where modulus of a less than 1 is required. So where in that slide shows the ROC's for modulus of a less than 1 and modulus of a greater than 1 when modulus of x of n is equal to a power n into u of n, and we have a z plane and the real and imaginary part r, and pole which is equal to a is which is equal to a, and it has a modulus of a less than 1 means it is a x anticausal signal, that is the ROC lies between the exterior part of the unit circle, and a modulus of a which is equal to a greater than 1 means we have a real and imaginary part. So in that case, exterior part of the unit circle, here we have a interior and exterior part of the unit circle both. The condition modulus of a less than 1 in that z plane. So this is a ROC topic. Are you able to understand? So next topic we will discuss in next class. Thank you, students.